But bro, like, so like your style and like sample choices at times, or just instrumentation, because it's not just a sample. I've seen your work. I've heard your stuff. I've seen the sessions. And this dude has a ton of layers. Yeah. So I really like the canvas that you're leaving for Mission. What's kind of like your approach to, do you think about Mission before you go to sleep? No, I'm kidding.
I was like, oh, please, please structure this question right. It's live.
Oh, no.
Let's get it.
Whatever you want.
Let's get it. Volume is. Oh, yeah. Slap it.
You want to grab that mic and just hold it?
Man, it's a big day. It is a big day.
Absolutely.
We got two dope releases.
It's the team, man. It's the team.
It's a team effort.
It's a team effort.
You guys don't see him right now, but we got AJ just running around doing all kinds of stuff.
Come back.
Teamwork make the dream work, baby. Thank you, man. Studio shot. Hold on. Studio shot.
So what are we going to do, man? Should we just go ahead and play the music and then talk about it?
Yep.
I feel like might as well.
All right. So what we're going to do right now, we're going to play the music and then we're going to talk about it. We're going to talk, you know.
Yeah, let's do it. First up, nitty-gritty. Lord Knows, man.
Let's get it. Lord knows. I'll play it. It's out right now. I'm about to play it on here. Y'all react to it. Let us know what y'all think. Produced by Mac Busy.
Y'all ready?
Yep. Oh, we don't got Spotify out here.
What?
I got Apple Music. Go to Apple Music.
Yeah.
One of them got Spotify. Well, I don't. I got Apple Music.
His music's on Spotify, but... I'm excited, man, for everybody to hear all this music.
Yeah. Let's go.
Yeah.
Uh-oh,
I did it again. In the zone. Yeah. I was calling them too, but they gone. Yeah, well, I have nothing to do with no funds. I'm only gonna give them the real on a song. Okay. I went after the dreamer, they told me to wait on the
I room. Like this song.
Okay. I went up for a minute, I see with my eyes, so how you gonna tell me I'm wrong? I don't do what they do, cause I'm different. Yeah. Ain't a part of their clique, cause I'm distant. I hit back and they say that I'm tripping. But I went at a place out, but I'm Christian. I look out for the crew like they missing. Yeah. I stand up like a man.
And if I did,
yeah. I was down and they ain't coming with it. Now I'm up and
my mom made a listen.
I fell on my knees, I couldn't fail me. Jealousy. I come from the trenches, I know where they mad. Ain't take the route they set for me. You fell in your face, I hope you get out. I pray you get up, you can't hang with us. I'm losing my trust.
It's yeah.
Two different cuts. Grew up broke, now we on the better thing. Pour toast, celebrate with the team. Abandoned house, they was doing chemistry.
Lord knows, things I shouldn't have seen.
Was low
broke, now they call him big bro. Lord knows. Swear to God, Lord knows, they spend a block, I'm barely alive.
Lord knows, yeah.
Man, I swear to God,
Lord knows, I've been getting to it.
Tryna make it happen.
Lord knows, I've been in my lane.
Go ahead, sing it, Mac.
What happened?
Sing it.
No, really. Can you hear it? Can you hear it on here?
We need Mac's version. Mac's version.
No, really.
Jesus, now your eyes. If I die first, then I try.
But now I'm saying it's number block. I can't follow you because you blind.
Can you drive
on skateboard? Got I grind.
Get West from the watch.
Get Romans, read the 10-9.
I've been doing more with the least of them. I see it up, I don't see nothing. But some peace coming, see the peace coming. I'ma eat from it on bad times. I'ma teach from it on keep. Know what I leave, but my soul, so I'm gon' preach from it. No guy got to save from me. Now we on a better thing. Pour toast, celebrating with the team. Abandoned houses, they were doing chemistry. Lord knows, since I shouldn't have seen was little bro. Now they call him big bro. Lord knows, swear to God, Lord knows. They spin the block, I'm barely alive. Lord knows, yeah. Now I swear to God.
Hey, pal.
No, yeah,
just slap.
He said, hey, pal.
Don't forget to pull your guys' mics up to you.
And did you believe in God?
Oh, yes.
Do
you
not believe in God?
No. Difficult to answer.
Difficult to answer.
I know. I don't need to believe. I know.
Fire! Whoa! I just wanted to yell into the microphone for the podcast. You know. Man, I feel like I'm in Mech Space.
No, you're good, man. Make sure y'all
okay.
Go get that right now. Ooh. It's out on all streaming platforms, Spotify, Apple Music, that Piff right now.
I don't know what else. Man, what are folks thinking there? Let's get some comments from the crowd, man.
What y'all think? Y'all rocking with that?
We'll take questions too.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah, we got if y'all want to do we got questions and everything.
Play the other. Yes, we got it coming. 16. They asked for 16-bit, Johnny.
All right. I'm going to play 16-bit now, and then we could talk about both.
We can talk about both, yeah.
Don't let it get old, you know?
Yeah.
Don't let it get old.
16. So look. Napster.
Oh. LimeWire.
LimeWire. Hey,
do you know
right
about
now
water?
We got
16
bit.
Live or lime?
Lime. No, he don't even know
about
lime.
Couldn't do it, man.
Featuring myself.
All of that.
After that, we're going to talk about these songs. We're going to get into it.
All right. The mic stands are cool, just they're not set. But you know what I mean?
You can move them. Oh,
I got it.
You could just stay with the scenes over here. They got it here. 16-bit.
Go 16-bit.
In my cup.
Sheesh.
I'm scared.
I thought you was dead. Where is it you come from? Was from the grave that the beast just altered. Thought he had a head. Still you talking like
a stoner.
Got a level up.
No fumble. 16-bit. That pound. 16-bit.
In my cup. 16-bit.
Like a Swiffer.
Do no telling, that's for you. You a whistler. I know you be capping and you capping. You got whiskers. Push up on the common fingers, beat down on the competition. Grooving, I just got the rhythm like a shining diamond.
Yes, we have the ball. We gotta get.
Yeah. You give them an inch, they taking them out.
You can't control them.
16-bit in my cup. 16-bit
level.
16-bit in my cup. 16-bit level.
What? Living water. That's a slaughter. Oh, my father.
You shouldn't even bother. I'm talking my talk, but I should have to show my brain. AOI, level up. Who said we can't? 16-bit mission in my cup. 16-bit level up. 16-bit in my cup. 16-bit level up. 16-bit in my cup.
That's slap.
Yeah, that's hard.
Yes, sir. They rocking with you in the comments, Johnny.
Thank you guys. I appreciate it, man.
Man, make sure y'all following Just Johnny IG, right?
IG Just Johnny Music.
Just Johnny Music.
Spotify Just Johnny. My real name is. No, I'm kidding. that's cool. Yeah. Just Johnny.
Make sure y'all following Mac Busy.
Absolutely. Mac Busy.
At Mac Busy. He's very busy man.
So can we start talking about these yes, songs, man? Let's Lord talk about knows them. Yep. The beat, Mac Busy.
Mac,
I mean, set the mood. How'd you come up with this, man?
Man, how did I come up with that? So I was actually in LA. It was crazy. I was in LA, I was dropping my brother off out in a college because he started college this semester out in CSUN. So he was in the hotel, and I always bring my little I just bring my little to go pack, basically. Mm-hmm. So it's like my little mini keyboard, my laptop, and my headphones. And I we just went out there, and then I was working on something, and I sent you a beat.
Right.
And then he's like, yeah, that's cool, man. He's like, to be honest, bro, I'm on something like Jimmy Cooks, man. Like, he was like, bro, he's on Jimmy Cooks hard for like.
I was on the song super hard.
I was like, oh my God, let me make this man some Jimmy Cooks. So I found this little thing. Chopped it up, did some woofy woo, add a little Mac sauce to it. Yeah.
Mac sauce?
Add a little Mac sauce to it.
Are you adopted that now?
I might.
I start calling them Mac sauce. And are you adopted it? Is it official?
I might.
Merch. I saw the Mac sauce shirt.
Oh, that's hard. That would be dope. Like for some merch, there Mac sauce.
That would actually be pretty hard. I can't lie.
Put some Mac sauce on your beats. On your production. Yeah, put some Mac sauce on your production.
I like that. Throw a little Mac sauce on it. But yeah, And then
you sent that to Mission that same day.
Yeah, essentially, because there was really nothing to do out there. I was just in the hotel, so I was just.
LA's got nothing to do, bro.
Where we was at, there was like. It was really nice.
Mission, what you think, man, when you got that beat? What?
When I heard the beat, I knew it was one of those ones.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, my gosh. When I heard the sample, I was like, okay. In my head, I was like, it has to drop right.
Yeah.
And I'm like, if it don't drop right, I'm going to be disappointed.
I'm going to be disappointed.
But when it dropped, no cap, I was like, whoa. Whoa. Yeah. So I was just like, so I start the song like that.
Yeah.
But it wasn't like. It was like premeditated. Like, as soon as I heard the beat, it made me just like, whoa, whoa. So when I heard it, man, I knew it was one of those ones because, like he said, like I was listening to the song by Drake. It's called Jimmy Cooks. And like, actually, I was writing to it because I was going to just drop like a little freestyle to the Jimmy Cooks instrumental. And then Max sent me some and I was just like, man, bro, this is what I'm on. This is the vibe I'm on right now. So when he sent it to me, bro, did I go right to work or I waited?
Nah, you went right to work. He like sent like heck of fire emojis. And he was like, all right,
that's what. Like, so okay. You guys, when Mission, when he is approving of something, it's fire emojis for a few lines. That's when you know.
That's when you know he got
when
one.
That's good.
If I like it, I'll be like, okay, yeah, this is dope.
Yeah, yeah.
But
yeah,
if I'm like, oh, I'm ready to go now, I'm gonna send you all type of fire emojis.
Just ready to go.
Yeah.
What
are folks? Do folks have any questions about this, man?
Y'all got any questions about the song? Any questions for me that I can answer right now? If not, LLC Flame, what's popping? I need a doctor. He killed that verse though. I'm not gonna cap. No question so
real
far.
Good stuff. No, that's real good stuff, man.
I'm gonna sit this over here because it's kind of awkward holding it, so we can kind of.
Oh
just,
yeah.
Or did?
AJ's just taking over.
Oh, let's talk about 16 bit then.
Yeah,
16 bit
in my.
Cook.
So all right, that's a true story, you know, about 16-bit. No, I'm kidding.
I'm going to be honest. Like, what do you mean by 16-bit? When I heard it, I was like, this is so dope. And I was like, I want to hop on it. But I was like, what does he mean by 16-bit?
Here's a true story behind this, right? So I bought a video game on PS4, Streets of Rage.
That's one 4, of my favorite games.
Right? And I was bummed out that they didn't have my favorite character that I used when I was a kid. I used Skate. So I make a reference to Skate. So the sounds that you hear on 16-bit, it's Skate, it's like him, his fighting moves. And all I wanted was to make a song with no melody. I just wanted samples, and I just wanted to hear him because I was playing the video game. So I was like, man, I miss Skate. So, and then that was back then, I mean, that was like Genesis 16-bit. Mm. Literally, I don't know why I said it, but I just said it. And that's what I've been doing, writing stuff. I just say the first thing, and it normally sticks. So 16-bit in my cup, and then Level Up just kind of went with it. It was, there's not much thought, man.
I knew I liked it, but I just like, because I know, like, all right, 16-bit, but I was like, where is he going with it?
Yeah, yeah.
Our verses had nothing to do with 16. Mine didn't.
Yours didn't. I make a few references to like 16-bit stuff. I said I got them red shoes like Sonic.
Oh, okay, 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 okay.
Yeah. There's also some other samples in there for those of you who love like samples. What's the video game?
Tetris?
Dang, it was on Genesis. It was Altered Beast. So it actually starts that way, and I say, I don't know my lyrics, but I say something about Altered Beast. Anyway, I like to use those samples on this particular one just because it was, that's all that was in my brain for that time. So I made this, literally, I was about to go to sleep, and then I was like, let me make a beat real quick on my phone for those of you who like apps, FL Studio for, you know, producers out there. Dope 808 sounds. And so I just made the beat on my phone, wrote to it real quick, and then came to HQ here, recorded it, I think. I sent it to Mission because I thought Mission would be dope on it. I'm like, well, let me send it with a blank verse. And so I sent it to you and...
Yeah, because I wanted to ask to hop on it, but I didn't want to just like, ah. Because we had did Ice Cream first, right?
Ice Cream, yep.
Yeah, so we did another song, and I hopped on that one. And then this one, I was like, dang, I don't even think I'm trying to hop on every song. But I was like, forget it. I'm going to just go for it. Hey, bro, can I get all this? And yeah, it was dope.
It's just having fun, really. Yeah. Like with the Just Johnny project, it's just about having fun. I'm just saying whatever's on my mind. Like some stuff is more like... down, I'm a Debbie Downer, more like depressing, but that's just reality. And then the other stuff is like, the other stuff is fun and upbeat and random. So I was like, yeah, I'm gonna send it to Mission. I mean, we just did another track, unreleased yet, but you guys will hear it. Ice Cream.
I kind of gave it up.
And then, it's all good though. This stuff, man, AOYNOM, we're on.
It's actually crazy how you made that with your phone too.
That's a big story within itself. The fact that he produced this on his phone.
So
that's crazy.
Do you like producing on your phone more? I mean, or
so I a few songs I started here at HQ, like at our setup, but after I think Ice Cream was the first one that was on my phone that I stuck to. No. Some of the structure, like the bones of the tracks, I made on my phone for a lot of the songs that I have. The majority, I'd say now, because I got a bunch of them. But I like that because I'm in a different space. Like, I love creating here. Like, you're in the zone. But sometimes I'm just like, most of the time it's late at night, and I'm just, you know, I just want to make a song real quick, and I'll throw something together, and then if I like
it. Are you with headphones, or you got your phone out?
The little earbuds.
Oh, okay,
yeah. I'm saying the 808 or the 808 samples and sounds on FL Studio, man, is just... it's crazy. So, like, the fact that you can get that sound. So, the sound that you guys hear on 16-bit, besides the voice samples, the drums and all that stuff, the 808s, it's all FL Studio. So, the 808s are crazy on a phone. So
that's crazy. Mac, are you using FL Studio to...
No, I don't use FL. But I do. I will say, I feel like I do need to hop on it. I just got to learn it. But
What'd you use to create Lord Knows?
So I use Logic. I use Logic. So I do that. You hate Pro Tools.
I don't hate Pro Tools. I just don't understand it. It's the same thing.
You know what's crazy is I actually find Pro Tools, when I first started using it, I found it relatively like simple to use.
It's not simple.
Like, I don't know. Like,
it just depends on where you start, right?
Yeah.
Well, I also think that comes from being a drummer and stuff. You see the measures and everything and all that right away.
Yeah.
Where, like, Logic is more, like, block-based. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, that's true. I do I like that on Pro Tools, though. But I started with Pro Tools. I didn't mess with Logic.
Pro Tools, I started with.
Pro Tools.
I think because I'm not an engineer, producer, nothing like that, I just want to record vocals.
Yeah.
I need it to be the
whatever. The simplest thing.
With Pro Tools, like I go in, I'll try to record something. I was like, dang, how do I get import the session? Yeah. How do I do this? Yeah. How do I
But it's the same thing, though. When we started HQ here, we didn't have Pro Tools yet. We had Logic first. So I actually had to learn Logic, and I was asking Mission, like, hey, bro, how do you do this? How do you do that? So I think it just depends on where you start from and what gear you're using.
It's like going from Android to iPhone.
Yeah. I'd
but also, though, look, I think though, with Pro Tools, it's not as simple as Logic. Logic, I was like, oh, this is easy. But I feel intimidated, like, trying to... Like, because some of the stuff, I was like, oh, that's easy. But they add like 10 more steps when Logic is just
I agree with that. I agree with that. But again, I feel like it comes down to like, okay, if you really want to learn it, like for the experts who want to do this in music, then yeah, you would use it. Because I agree with you. Like it is like more steps to do something when you can do it in less steps in Logic.
What do you feel, Mac? Do you feel like does it give you more control because there's more steps in between kind of thing?
Yeah, in a sense, right? It does kind of give me more. Okay, so for example, right? So you know in Pro Tools how you can make, when I first started using Pro Tools, right? In Logic, there's a feature if you go into the mixer, if you just select all the tracks, you can drag mm-hmm. all the faders down or solo all of them. In Pro Tools, you have to create a group for all of them, and then you have to adjust it. And then every single time you adjust it, if the group is on, it messes with all of them. So it's like, but at first I was like, oh, I hate this. But then as I started using them more, I'm like, okay, I can kind of understand. And then there are times where I hate it, and there are times where I like it. So it's just, I don't know. If I want to keep the same, I don't know, yeah.
I think it just depends on what your flow is. Like, yeah. you don't want to spend time thinking about steps A, B, C, D, like whatever works for you, like just get to work. Because like at the end of the day, especially for producers, it's about like that sound. You just want to find that sound and just start building. For Mission, it's like you just want to get your vocals down. If you're messing with all these knobs and all these buttons, it's like it just kills your
flow.
Yeah, for sure.
And I will say the sound, the finished product
that Pro Tools gives
is
different. It's different for sure.
I didn't think it was a difference at first.
It's different.
But I was like, nah, there is a difference.
It's crazy because actually, I took a session when I first got it. I took a session in Logic and I dropped it in Pro Tools. I kid you not, I did absolutely nothing and it sounded way better. I'm like, what just happened?
I was actually confused.
Yeah. I know it's something in the DAW for sure. Because each DAW has their own. So for example, Logic actually kind of makes. From what I've noticed, Logic low-key actually makes tracks kind of darker, like a little darker. So you kind of have to add a little bit more brightness to it if that's what you prefer.
Ableton DAW is Digital Audio Workstation, right? Mm-hmm. I learned that from Johnny.
We had to teach this stuff.
Yeah.
So you know, it really does depend. But I actually like Pro Tools mixing in it.
Yeah. So So obviously you finished Lord Knows in. Because I recorded in Logic.
Yeah.
So did you finish it in Logic?
So I finished the beat in Logic, and then I exported all to Pro Tools, you know, got the final mix with your vocals in it.
Did you mess with the sounds in Logic, or you just threw them in Raw?
No, that's kind of why I like using Logic. So I have, like for my 808s and stuff like that, I have settings that I built already. So that by the time I put them in, or like by the time I load it up, it's kind of already sounding the way I want it to.
Oh, dope.
And then when I put it in, when I export it all to Pro Tools, all I really have to do is kind of adjust it depending on the vocal and kind of how I want it to sound overall in the mix. But for the most part, it sounds...
It doesn't matter, right? Like, I think because I recorded 16-bit in Logic, too.
Yeah.
Since obviously the finished product sounds better, does it make a difference if I record in Logic versus recording it in Pro Tools and you guys getting that WAV file from Pro Tools versus Logic?
No, I think what makes a difference is just making sure that like the fundamentals are right, that the audio's not clipping, that it's a good source. One like a saying is like garbage in, garbage out. Like if you send a trashy signal, you can't make it better.
Exactly.
But you recorded it well, it wasn't clipping, it wasn't distorting. And then you have to mix it based on the beat, right? Like depending on how many instruments there are, how empty it is. Like 16 bits, like super empty. There's just like a few sounds. Mm-hmm. So I didn't have to take a lot of the body out of like your voice and stuff like that, and just kind of like adjust it. I don't think there's an issue with it. Like you know, recording. We got good gear. We got some good gear, guys. Some real nice stuff at AYNOM Studios HQ.
HQ.
So just real quick, So I kind of found out a little bit more about 16-bit and where that came from. It's actually really dope. I didn't know it came from a video game. That's kind of cool. Where did Lord Knows, where did that kind of come from?
Yeah.
I think...
What was the process? Because I remember like the first version we had.
Yeah.
And then we went through revisions. But then, but like just in general, where did it
come from? I'm getting back to, in my music, I'm getting back to like, I guess my roots. So that's why I'm like, I grew up broke. But it's like more, I want to say, like I wasn't doing commercial stuff, but it was kind of Christian commercial.
Yeah.
But now I'm getting back to like raw and uncut. Like, so.
What do you mean by that? Is it like storytelling?
Storytelling, more like where I grew up, where I come from, like kind of just saying it raw and uncut, saying it like how I was saying, like, because obviously I didn't curse, but I was like seeing some I shouldn't have seen. And like you kind of like fill in the blank. Like,
yeah, exactly.
But that's how I felt. And like, obviously I have a responsibility to make sure that my music is clean and stuff like that, which I love doing. I don't have a problem with
For
that.
Sure.
But like just giving my raw emotion within the parameters of, you know.
So I don't know if you guys know, but I'm a fan of Mission's music, like a true fan. A long time ago, so we tried to work together like years ago. Facts. Like Mission was just starting out. I was on my way down, you know. I was like, I'm a washout right now, but anyway,
Johnny was the man.
Hey, but I wanted to work with Mission because I'm like, this dude has really good sound. I really like what you were doing. And then at one point, like music started getting like real commercial.
Yep.
And I was like, and I really love Mission storytelling. And then at one point you were like simplifying it a little bit, just for style. And it's great. Like being able to like 16-bit, come on. There's no, the storytelling there is kind of lacking, guys. But like Mission sound and style, I really like when you do the storytelling. And this, it was real descriptive, like like the word choice.
Yep.
The selection, the placement, like it's really good, man. Is there anything else about on this? I know you're saying that it's like raw and uncut. Yeah. Like, is there more that you're pulling in, like from?
Absolutely. There's like you can hear my frustrations with, like, you know, like I say, I hit back, and you know they say that I'm tripping. So it's like there's things that's been done to me that like, you know, and it's like when I react to it, it's like, oh no, you're the bad guy now. So I like I put a lot of frustrations into this song. Like it's like crypt and like encrypted. Yeah. So it's just like I'm not really saying exactly what it is, but if you listen, like listen, I'm clearly talking about something, someone maybe, not the one in particular, but like a lot of things that's been done. And it's just like I kinda got that underdog, you know, on me right now, you know, because it's like you know, I've been doing it for so long, and like, there's this expectation that people put on me that I didn't put on myself. It's like, bro, you're supposed to be here now. Yeah. You're supposed to be blown up now. And it bothers me because I'm like, y'all put that on me. Like, I didn't do that. So it's one of those things, like a lot of the music that you'll be hearing from me, like over these next couple months, is going to be a lot of emotion. It's going to be pain. That's it's going to be joy. It's going to, you know, I'm back to that, you know, in the beginning days where I kind of just put it all out there and, you know.
I really like that, the fact that you're, like, just the raw. Like, I prefer artists that are more raw and less refined in terms of, like, a super ultra-produced sound that's, like, too clean. Yeah. So it's crazy how, I mean, we got Mac on the team producing. And Mac, like, you have that, like, that flavor that, like, in your arsenal. Because Mac produces a bunch of stuff. He, like, he's done, like, soul, neo-soul, R&B, hip-hop, like, all kinds of stuff. Trap, mariachi,
mariachi. Of that. All of
jazz.
That.
But, bro, like, so like, your style and, like, sample choices at times or just instrumentation, because it's not just a sample. Like, you really, I've seen your work. I've heard your stuff. I've seen the sessions. And this dude has a ton of layers that it's crazy how you blend it, and it's really, it seems like it's cohesive. It's like, it doesn't sound like a sample and then like a bunch of random instruments. Like, it really blends together.
Yeah.
So I really like the canvas that you're leaving for Mission. What's kind of like your approach to, do you think about Mission before you go to sleep? No, I'm kidding.
I was like, oh, please, please structure this question right.
How often do you think about it? That's actually really funny. It was crazy when I first met him. The second time I met him, because I actually met him like 4 years ago. We're not gonna get that. But
did you know that?
No.
It's crazy because how everything
comes back full
circle. Let me share this.
I'm going to hear it if he's going to say it.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
So it's like, how you spoke about, like, we were supposed to work in the beginning. Yeah. Same with him. Like, we met each other back in the day. We were supposed to work. he wasn't that good then.
Oh, no way.
That was bad.
Wait, do you remember him when you met him? Oh, man.
I was like, I don't know where from.
Were you Mac busy? Don't do it again?
No, really. That's really what it was, too.
You tag.
Same with AJ. We've been supposed to be.
Bro.
So anyway, my bad.
Yeah, no,
everything is coming back full circle. My bad.
Yeah, no, but essentially, yeah. So the second time I met him when I was here, I had more of like a... so this is where like the R&B side kind of popped out a little bit more because I like melodies and mm-hmm. melodic type beats and stuff. And he's like, oh yeah, that's cool, da da da. But as I started kind of working with him a little bit more, I realized he likes things to just knock. He just want his beats knocking.
Yep.
And so I'm like, okay, that's cool. You know, I ain't got no issue with that. So I mean, that's a lot of now kind of what I'm thinking about is, okay, if I'm gonna make a beat for Mission, it's like, okay, like, how can I make it knock? But at the same time, still have like a melodic type of element to it to where it's not doing too much, but you can still like, you can still feel it and it's like, okay, this is cool.
Well, but even, mission accomplished with Lord Knows, because that thing knocks. I mean, we got a sub in here at HQ, so it was like knocking, but then there's still the melody, the grittiness. Go ahead, man, I cut you off.
No, you're good. Yeah, no, but so I mean, but it really depends. Even, I mean, I'm not going to say the name, but the other one that we got.
Go ahead, you good?
You know, if I'm honest?
If I'm honest, yeah.
Yeah, so I mean, if I'm honest, I know for real, I'm not going to say too much about that one, but that one's great. That one's great. I love that one, but
it's catering is more your...
Yeah, it's a lot more melodic. Mm-hmm. It's soul. But yeah, I mean, it's still, he's still talking on it. You know what I'm saying? He's still got that storytelling element to it. Yeah.
I can't wait to talk to you guys about that one once we get to that point. But I mean, you guys got some really good music like on deck, man. Like, I don't know, if for those of you guys who have been rocking with Mission for a while, like I've heard his work, and there's levels. Like within the time frame that we've been working together, like absolutely. I've seen the progression. Because so I'm a producer and audio engineer as well. I do my own music, like visuals, like video,
photographer, graphic designer.
I'm terrible at everything else in life, but this stuff is kind of I'm okay at. But I've seen the progression, like sonically, like hearing. It's hard. I think I've seen more artists stay kind of stagnant and have like one sound and just stick to it and that's it. Like they might do it well, but they just stick to that and it works. But there's some stuff that Mission has, like some stuff that like will be released that it's like, dude, there's levels. And so do you do anything in particular to like, how do you like mix your sounds or how do you choose your sounds? Cause like your voicing and stuff kind of varies from track to track and it's real. It doesn't sound like, it sounds authentic is what I'm saying.
Right. I just cater to whatever the instrumental is. Like once I get the beat, like, cause I'm not like, it's rare that I'm thinking like I have an idea for a song and I'm like, hey, Mac or Johnny, hey, I have this idea. Mm-hmm. It's always like, I'm waiting to like what to get whatever I receive.
Yeah.
And I think it's better that way because it doesn't put, I mean, with the exception of like, Lord knows, I was like, I need a Jimmy Cooks type of thing. Cause it was just, I was in that vibe. But like, I don't want to hinder the producer. Like, cause that's a creative side that they have to have. Like, that they, like, me and Kenny do that well, where he kind of just makes his beat and all his emotions and his creativity is in it. And, you know, he's kind of just free to do whatever. And then he sends me the beat. And then now it's like, now all my creativity and all what I'm feeling about it, I can put that in there instead of, you know, kind of just like, it's good to have an idea every now and again, but I just kind of just flow with it, man. Whatever the instrumental is, I just go with it.
For sure. That's really good stuff, man. We got AJ.
We got a question right now. Johnny, what's your favorite Mission song? And Mission, what's your favorite Johnny song?
Oh.
Man, that's a good question. I really don't know Mission's the titles of his songs. I really don't. Man, I'd have to say, I'm not biased on this one. You guys haven't heard it yet, but I've heard it. It's called Empty.
Empty.
I just threw it out there. Empty. When you guys hear Empty, when that comes out, you're going to be like, Mission is just, you're going to understand what I'm saying, like about levels. Like there's just different voicing, different, it's just crazy. I can't wait for you guys to hear it. I'd have to say Empty for me, bro.
Yeah. For mine, I think it's more, I like the newer stuff that he's been doing, the stuff that you guys haven't heard yet. But for me, it's production. Like he produced this, and I tell you about it, the God Squad song.
Oh, yeah.
Man,
Go Smart.
Go Smart. That's God. So, but then rolling down my back like water off a duck's back.
Yeah.
So it was the production that like that I'm more of a fan of. Because I didn't really get into, you know, when you were doing the, I don't want to say techno. Was it? It wasn't.
It's like electronic.
Electronic.
EDM. It's like EDM before EDM was EDM.
Yeah.
Pretty much. It
was... Johnny, you were ahead of your time, bro. Like, back when Johnny was killing it, there wasn't a really a space for it.
I didn't feel like there was a space for it. Like, yeah. I had support. I had a lot of supporters, but it was like, who Nobody do I do shows with?
Like, exactly. Like, who do you pair with? But you were ahead of your time because it was so... It was so ahead, such ahead of his time. We didn't know what to do with it. I would say more like, obviously, in the zombie song was like zombie. Yeah. That was dope live, but I would say it's more like some of my favorite songs that you produced.
I think there's something to it when you were talking about your approach to songwriting. I have a very similar approach to it. So because I produce my own stuff, I feel like. If the music, it already has a feeling and an emotion to it, so it pulls like lyrics out, right? So it's gonna draw that out from me. So I feel like when I'm creating an instrumental, it already has an idea, and then I literally most of the time I'm just like mumbling a melody or cadence, and then I just write. If I like that cadence, then I'll write to it because I will always have something to say. Like it might be random or it might be real, I don't know, just different things. So I feel like it already has that emotion behind the instrumentals. I don't know, Mac, do you feel the same way about your instrumentals? Do you feel like you're saying something with your music, like emotion-wise? Or?
Absolutely. I would say that. I would say, in terms of, it's more so kind of just like a feeling. So, I mean, I really, really love music. It's always kind of, for lack of a better phrase, I know it's really cliche, but it's always spoke to me, you know.
Really.
I mean, it's super cliche. Oh, the music spoke to me, but I mean, it really does. Like, it definitely says something to me when I'm listening to stuff. I guess when I'm producing or when I'm coming up with chords and stuff like that. I remember one time too, and I'm not trying to read my own press clippings or nothing, but I remember I was showing some beats to this group out in the Bay. They're a Christian group. These three girls. And I played this beat. It was still really not that good, if I'm being honest. But the chords that I had played, they're actually really good in my opinion. Old girl, she started crying. She's crying for like 20 minutes. I'm like, wow. I was sitting there. I was like, what do I do? Because I don't know what I'm doing right now. But what happened, AJ?
If I could add, me and Johnny did a podcast, and he said something pretty cool that he said, like, music is like a language that everybody can understand for
absolutely.
Sure.
Absolutely, absolutely, yeah. Because, I mean, and the crazy thing about that, too, is that people will get different interpretations of, different songs. So, I mean, it is a language that's quite universal, but it also has many different interpretations, if that makes sense.
We do have another question. What's the next food spot you guys are going to?
Ooh. Man, I'm kind of hungry right now.
If I wasn't running late, I was going to get some food, but.
I don't know. Well, one dish or I don't know where we're going to have them, but I want to take Mission. To try pupusas. I don't know. I'm Salvadorian from El Salvador, actually born there.
Me too.
Yeah, Mission too. Me and Mission, man, we left the Civil War. We got over here and mixed music.
The Civil War.
But I think that's a food for sure, for sure, for sure. Because Mission hasn't had them.
I have not had them.
And I'm like, how do you, like in California, there's a bunch of Salvadorian folks. And if you've been to the Bay, San Francisco, a bunch of like pupuserias is what you call them. And so I'm excited for Mission to try those.
Yeah,
I
can't wait.
Yeah, bro.
I mean, yeah, you talked him up. So
I feel like I would be offended if he doesn't like them. I haven't met anyone who hasn't liked them.
Honestly. I've heard only good things about them.
That's cool.
I've actually never.
You
had
probably got to go with us, Matt.
Yeah, we got to have Matt.
I've never.
You're a foodie?
You like absolutely. Them? I love Hispanic food too. So I mean.
So there you go. Mac's gonna be on the next episode too, trying some pupusas.
Let's try it.
Got any other questions back there, AJ? AJ's working,
not at the moment.
Hey, man, give it up for AJ, everybody.
Absolutely.
Clapping.
Absolutely.
Dude, this whole setup, AJ, man, just like, so, oh.
At the
oh,
speed of light, too. He was.
I forgot to mention, for those of you who, at some point today, 16-bit, we did a music video.
Video.
I forgot. But it's there.
You know what? We could watch it live in here, and I'll put it post in the.
Dope.
Yeah, if you guys want to do that, go ahead and keep talking.
Yeah.
Let's do that. That's
so,
cool.
So, I want to tell you guys a little bit about my life. I'm kidding. No, what were you saying, Mitchell?
I know we kind of skipped past it, but when we're talking about the storytelling, Weekend was the...
Oh, Love You for the Weekend.
Love You for the Weekend.
I actually really like that song.
That was the story, right? Like,
yeah.
Tell us about that.
So, Love You for the Weekend is the first single that I came out with a few weeks back. And so that one was actually the first song that I made for the Just Johnny project. So that's the one that kind of started off. Actually, I wasn't even planning on making music. I was just planning on working and creating stuff for Mission, and that's it. I didn't have any intention on like making music. So if you guys like my music, thank Mission, because he's the one who said like, "Hey, bro, why don't you just start writing some new songs or something?" I was like, okay, yeah.
And then you'll go started, for it.
And then I just started. So I Love You for the Weekend was the first one. It's really just a real song. A lot of these songs that you're going to hear have like real lyrics. So I'm being very, which I didn't do before, like all my previous music in different bands or as like solo artists and stuff. It was kind of like encrypted in there. Like, what's he really saying? With these, I'm just saying, like, I think I started off at, wake up, I already want to get away. I just want to lay in bed all day. Got some problems I don't want to face. I just want to see her pretty face. I mean, it's straightforward.
it's right.
As you listen to it, though, you know, like, I'm trying to be as transparent and relevant as possible. So I'm making music not for people. Like, I'm just making it for myself. It's very therapeutic. Yeah. It's like just pouring myself out.
Yeah. That's a... It's not a heavy line, but it's kind of a, okay, so the line, I swear to love you for the weekend.
Oh, yeah.
That's both shady. It's like, I only got enough love for the weekend.
Yeah.
But it's also like, it makes me like, dang, like, where does that come from?
That's
like,
a good question.
You know, like.
I haven't asked myself that yet. No, I'm kidding. Yeah. So it goes, it's like there's a duality about it because it could be me saying that. So these are from real experiences and really it's about relationships, right? So it could be from the aspect of the other party, like only having that much love just for the weekend. Like, I swear to love you for the weekend only. It's a short bit of time and then it's over. Or then myself also, like, I've been in that situation where I'm like, it's only going to be for a short time. Mm. I swear to love you for the weekend. Then the next line is, no one can break your heart like she can. Pretty self-explanatory. Yeah. So it just goes on and on from there. And here's another thing about that. I made that instrumental because that was the first one that I made. I made it here at HQ, and I wrote the hook from my drive from HQ to my house. It was done. Wow. Like, I just wrote it. That's what I felt, in the car.
Wow.
So a lot of these I've written just in the car, like from HQ back home.
As you were driving.
Mm-hmm.
And some of them produced, too.
Multi-talented.
Oh, yeah. Some I actually... Don't text and drive.
I was going to say, you wrote a whole...
It's against the law.
You wrote a whole...
But they didn't say nothing about production.
It was crazy, too, because when you had put that clip of the movie with the song...
Oh, yeah,
it fit
perfectly.
Like, it actually fit perfectly. Like, I could definitely see it in a Netflix movie or something like that.
Netflix, pick it up, man.
Absolutely.
Pick up Love You for the Weekend. I think I put it on Nick and Nora's Infinite Playlist. I think that's what it's called.
Mm-hmm.
But basically, it's just an emotional song. It's really like a downer in a sense. So one thing that I with my music, it's either for the daytime or the nighttime. Like if you're in your feelings, listen to some of these at night. So like Love You for the Weekend is like one of those night ones.
Yeah.
Like for your drive or whatever. There's gonna be a few others like that. 16-bit is definitely just a hype song. It's just fun.
In my
bumping. Cut.
We're gonna make a country version too.
16
bent in my truck.
Are you guys ready to share the video?
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Oh, you haven't seen it, huh?
No, I haven't seen it. It's raw.
I thought you was dead when you exit, you come from. It's from the grave, not the beast, just altered. Daddy had a head.
Level up, 16 bit in my cup.
That's hard. That's hard. How you feel like the end right there? That's hard.
A-Y-N-O-M.
A-Y-N-O-M.
So you guys, I think you had it flipped the other way. No. Grammarly. I didn't produce that track.
That's funny.
So the video, how, like...
Bro, here's what's crazy about it. So if you guys, hopefully you guys already, like, checked out my Spotify, the artwork, you'll see me and Mission as drawings. So...
Which you did.
I made that, right? I did that artwork, and that was the image in my mind before the video. It's like, I wanted to do that. Mm-hmm. I wanted it to be like... So a few things. I wanted to randomly be in a hockey mask. You guys... So I didn't plan it for Halloween, guys. Like, people might think it just, like, lined up that way. But I bought that mask a few months ago. When I made the track, I was like, I just want to wear a mask.
I just want to get a mask.
I just want to do that. I'm real random like that, and that's what I wanted to do. And then once we got... Well, that was my idea. Once we got Mission, when you recorded your part, I was like, I got to sketching a little bit shortly after that. And the whole concept, you guys, AJ, who's our... a jack of all trades. This dude is crazy good with video stuff. It's really hard as a video producer to like entrust your vision to somebody else.
Yeah.
And for them to execute it. This video was a one shot video. Mm. Like there were no cuts, no edits. It's one shot. So it took 17 times, but we got it. 17 times. Because it's, and that's crazy. It speaks to like the work ethic of everybody who was a part of that. If you check out the video, you'll see the credits at the end. A bunch of folks helped out. I think it was like seven folks behind the camera.
Yeah.
And dude, so I, the story just kind of wrote itself in a sense. I wanted to start off on the ground like I did with the car in front. Like I like stories where people can kind of draw their own conclusions. You know what I mean? And then, because somebody asked me, I don't know, somebody from our team was like, were we in a car crash? I'm like, oh, yeah, we're in a car crash. Yeah, or at some point, basically, maybe somebody else, I don't know. But with this, there's, I like the challenge of, like, on every video, trying to do something different. So I don't know if you guys know, but I did the video for Liu Kang.
Yes.
And there's a story within that. And fire. I just like making a story within...
fire.
Yeah. Like, the song might not have anything to do with that concept, but there's a story.
Yeah.
We do have a question. It says, can I borrow that camera in the studio?
No.
And then,
who asked?
Somebody asked out, is this out yet? How can I see this?
It's on YouTube already. Just Johnny. I think my channel is Just Johnny, right, AJ?
Yeah, Just Johnny.
So AJ, man, he does so much. Behind the scenes, dude, like everything that we you see videos and all these clips and TikTok. I'm on TikTok also, Just Johnny. I don't know. AJ runs it. He's dope.
I will say, when you were saying handing like over the vision to me to executing the video, it's super easy because me and you kind of vibe off each other a lot and we're pretty much on the same frequency.
Yeah,
so
for sure.
You make it easy for me because you put the vision like that I would usually have.
It's crazy how we all connect. I mean, we are a team. We're only missing Dennis right now. I believe Dennis is our merch dude. He's super like the beast. Visuals.
Oh, we'll get him on the podcast.
You guys see the hat? Did we plug the hat already? I mean, do you guys want this hat or what?
A couple people said like, man, this hat is fire.
Yeah.
I think on the next merch drop, we
got
drop
it.
This.
When I saw Mission wearing it, I was like, man. Yeah.
This is an exclusive one of one.
It's one of one.
Speaking of merch real quick, just another plug. AOYNOM.com.
AOYNOM.com.
All kinds of merch that you can order. I think we only have a few of the hats left, maybe. Yeah. Do we? I don't know.
We don't have this colorway yet.
No,
but
no.
The stitched are all sold out.
Oh, never mind. I just... broke your hearts.
But yeah, go visit it. But let's talk about that team. Like, I think that's something that I've longed for and I've had teams but I think for sure, like with how this came together, it goes back to like how God is kind of making things come full circle. We've been wanting to work. We were supposed to work. And same with AJ and me and Dennis kind of have the same story because we started working and it didn't work out. And then we took some time, and then we kind of came back. Mm-hmm. So it's just like a lot of people see, like even when my partner Brandon came on live, it was like, bro, I love the consistency. And then for me, I'm just like, yeah, like they're seeing me, but it's like, it's all this other stuff going on behind the scenes. Like I want to be able to release a song every month. You know how much easier that is now? Because I have YouTube. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I want to do content and like...
That's a hint.
Yeah.
You know how much easier it is now to... And it's still work. We still got to do the work. But having a team of people that is down for the vision, that's down for you, and you're reciprocating that back, down it makes things so much easier and it lightens the load. And like, I don't ever want that to go unnoticed.
Yeah.
Like, because a lot of people are like, yeah, man, me and the team, but they don't really have a team.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I'm blessed.
We have a team.
We have a freaking team.
Yeah, facts.
We have, so all of you, none of me, it's not just a tagline. It literally is our, like, all of us go to bat for each other. Like, if somebody needs, like, when someone's on, they're on, and everybody's there to support that vision.
Facts.
So that's what I love about being part of the team. I mean, and this was recent for me. I joined towards the end of 2021. Mm-hmm. Right?
Yep.
Are we in 2022? Yeah.
You're almost a year in.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yep.
But it's a lot has happened. It's crazy how, like, all the provisions, like, God has done so much for us. Yeah. Like, we have the headquarters. We have, like, the way that everything is working out, to have folks that are really in it to help each other out. Like, we do gain something from it. Like, when I'm doing my music, it's like, you know, we have the supporting cast for it. When Mission's working on something, you know, we're looking for ways to really support everybody that's a part of the team. And so it's not just like a tagline that's to be cute, all of you know to me.
Yeah.
It like, that is a mentality. And actually that's, you know, Mission and I were talking about that. Like, that's what we want to continue to have with this. It's never going to be just about one person or two people. Like,
I don't think you'll be able to exist on this team if you have a mentality that it's all about you.
Yeah.
Facts.
Because they're like, it's just like, Me, we were talking, it's like, hey, there's gonna come a time where it's just not about Mission right now, and I have to be okay with that. Yeah. And it's just like, I'm not gonna shy away, and I'm not gonna put a lot of effort into it. It's not my time. Yeah. It's like, nah, if this is about Johnny, then we need to go hard. Like, we went out there, it was cold, it was, you know, it doesn't matter though.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, it's, hey, bro, let's get this, however many times it take.
Yeah.
That's how many times we're going to do it. And it's the same.
Yeah.
You shoot editing videos and it's like, hey, make this change. Man, I just spent, okay, boom. We going, you know what I'm saying? And the same with you. Mac sent me like 60 revisions to Lord knows, but it's about getting it right.
Yeah.
And it's just like, all right, it's not about me right now.
Everybody's putting in work. And again, I say behind the cameras, we got AJ.
Absolutely.
This dude, he does like everything. So he's on the audio side. So he also does like engineering and stuff like that. Yep. He does video, the podcast stuff. Dude, he put all the padding up in the booth. So for our recordings and stuff, it just improved the quality. Just built a cloud. I mean, just so much. But that's the heart behind it all, really, and behind everybody. And I think that's why we're gonna you know, see, get good quality and good results out of it.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Sheesh.
Sheesh.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
We got two bangers that just dropped today. That's crazy.
Two bangers.
You know, it wasn't even supposed to happen that way, but the fact it did, it just brings the team closer together.
Exactly.
For sure.
And we're both supporting it, both like...
Yeah.
It's not, oh, well, my song's more important or your song's
really
more important.
Overlap,
like, it's just like, bro, no, okay, we released them the same day. Let's both, let's
do it.
You know, we got to put so much content out now anyway. So it's just like, let's keep it moving.
We're just moving. Man. We got a lot of stuff.
Man. You said you're trying to release a song every month?
Every month. It has to happen.
What's next?
I don't know, bro. I don't know.
What it's not like you're not sitting on music.
Right. I got a heck of stuff. You know what? I'm being picky because it goes back to me saying like I just feel like I have to prove something. Like,
yeah.
And not in a, it's just like a.
Like you got a chip on your shoulder.
A chip on my shoulder right now. Like, I feel like the underdog. And I feel like, man, who y'all talking to? Like, I can do this.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm like making sure like what I drop, but I do want to drop the stuff we've done. Like I haven't forgot about that. I want to drop.
It's just different flavors. It's so much. We got a lot for you guys. For those of you who have been rocking with Mission for a while, or if you're newer to his music, man, there's still more. There's so still more, more coming. This, I mean, this was a dope drop. Lord knows that. Lord knows.
Lord,
knows. Bro. No, seriously, man. I'm a real fan of the music, and even with Mac and his production, like as he's adapted to like the demand, so to speak, right? Like Mission, there's a certain sound he's looking for, a certain level of knockality.
Is that right?
Knockality. Mac just comes through, bro.
Come through, yeah.
Appreciate it.
It's dope.
I think that's so dope how, like, and that's when I knew that, like, because at first I kind of wrote you off as, I saw this dude's an R&B producer. Like, I was like, oh, yeah, he'd be dope for, like, you know, some R&B stuff. Mm-hmm. And because when you first came, you was playing all these melodies. I was like, yeah, this is dope. But I was like, what am I going to do with this?
What am I going to do with it?
And man. Then, like, I seen how you was able to, like, take me kind of just like, ah, Mac, I don't really like that. Because, like, I'm testing him. I was like, man, let's see how, you know, let's see if he can. Nah, I don't like that one. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
And you adapt it well, and you, like, you making doper beats. It's like you're getting better every beat. I'm like, damn, this dude is getting cold with it, man. So I think praise that's dope God. How you can adapt, bro.
I think he's bringing the sauce.
The sauce. Mac sauce.
Mac sauce.
Mac sauce.
You gotta get that on the hoodie for sure.
Shirts and hoodies coming soon. Probably a bottled version.
A bottled version.
AJ, where is this podcast going to be available?
So it's going to go on Mission's YouTube channel, and from there we'll probably announce an official podcast name for him. So from there, I think it would be a good time to announce it on your YouTube channel.
We got the name.
Yeah, we do. You want to announce it?
Yeah, generally speaking.
Oh,
generally speaking.
Yeah. So all the real fans know. Yeah. You did the first generally speaking.
Yeah.
That's crazy. The first video that you did was generally speaking.
There's actually one before that, random. I just remembered.
Which one?
It was just like a little clip. I don't remember what it was, but it was at like the RLC building.
Tell me, did it have signs that came up into the video?
Did we ever finish it though?
It was a quick promo thing, so it wasn't a full
song. Yes, I remember, and I had the Bible out.
I gotta find it.
Oh my God!
Wait. If you find it, we gotta react to that now.
We have to.
Yeah, because I haven't seen it in a long time either.
Oh my gosh, I do remember that.
But generally speaking, you hit me up. It was from one day to the next. You're like, hey, bro, do you think we shoot a video? And we made it happen. We just
made it happen. And that was the song. That song, wow. Now that I'm thinking about it, that song, it was like the first song to where people started taking me serious.
That's crazy.
And I remember.
Generally speaking, you're talking about?
Yes.
Yeah.
I did it at the Crave, at his Crave.
Mm-hmm.
And bro, like when the beat dropped, everybody went crazy. But you see, it's like, all right, generally speaking, you shot the video. I'm doing it at his concert. They had this concert. It's called The Crave. Yeah. They used to pop. They used to go crazy. Yeah. I don't know, man. It's just, it's so full circle. It's blowing
There's
my
a
mind.
Ton of history. Thanks. And
the history.
I think it's exciting to kind of share that with both of the people who are still watching. No, I'm kidding. I don't know.
Right. Who else is on. Is anybody on there?
Is anybody on?
Yeah, we got three right now.
Oh, I
welcome,
was close.
Everybody. Welcome.
Oh, a grand total.
Invite your friends. I'm kidding. No,
I gotta tell you, through this whole live though, we've had about 40 different people come in.
That's great. Hey. But for the three that are there right now, extra, I'm gonna give you a discount code. MacSauce20. MacSauce2020.
Sauce is spelled with the buddy side.
Yeah. But
that's funny.
I think that the history behind all of this is crazy how there's a lot to share. Like folks didn't know this. Like, and some of this stuff, like, we're like, oh, yeah, I didn't know about you guys, you know, having, like, encountered each other, like, at some point before actually working and stuff like that. So I think it makes the music experience richer. So for those of you who are hearing the backstory and these connections, you'll know if we're ever working on something together, like, it's got some real, some really strong ties, pretty much.
Right.
Like, some real good stuff.
Hearing this.
Absolutely.
A grand total.
A grand total of three.
You're stupid.
We fell off. No.
It's cool. We appreciate you three. For real, for real.
Man.
Thanks, Mom. I'm kidding.
Right.
This is probably a good time to wrap up the podcast, generally
Absolutely.
Speaking.
Yeah.
You want to give us a sign-off mission?
Hey, man, make sure you go right now, Spotify, Apple Music, anywhere you can download or stream music. You're not downloading music anymore. Anywhere you can stream music and get 16-bit featuring myself. Also go get Lord Knows by me, produced by Mac Busy. Make sure you following Just Johnny Music.
Just Johnny Music on IG.
IG.
Just Johnny, JustJonnie. That search should, and no space.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Make sure you are following Mac Busy. It's
MacBusy_DIA.
Cool guy. MacBusy_DOA.
I think if you guys go to the AOYNOMMG, AOYNOM Instagram, you're going to see all of us.
See all of us.
There.
Giving all these at names.
Make sure you're following Solified. As well,
Solified.
I was Sully. Sola.
Sola. Make sure what do we call it? Sullified.
Sullified. Me. So it's sola fide, which means just faith alone in Greek. Oh. I think. But yeah, Sullified Studio for and Sullified Podcast for the podcast.
Absolutely. Make sure you follow that. Make sure you follow me. LYNOMG. Thank you guys for tuning in.